And we have to only 1 minute to become this one. And we have to drag it. Drag it to that will come.
Oh, sorry for the inconvenience. Well, so we're just talking about what is called as the food security and increasing population and decreasing land for cultivation. So land value, I mean land kam hota ja raha hai, and the mouse to be fed is increasing. So looking at that, how we are going to increase the production of food grains as well as the fruits, vegetables, etc. So now the question is, will it be possible for us to have this kind of cultivation, what is that known for us, for quite long time? So hum the shuru se farming kar raha tha, so it's a mostly manual, the entire family, pura family ka log kaam karte the khet mein, fir bhi itna fasal nahi aata tha. So baad mein aise hamara India mein एक रेवोल्यूशन हो चुका है. हेड ऑफ ऑपरेशन फ्लड, कभी सुना है आपने ऑपरेशन फ्लड? कैन एनीबडी टेल मी?
नो सर.
नो. ओके सो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू नो अमूल? अमूल?
यस सर.
यस सर.
यस सर.
अमूल स्टैंड्स फॉर
अमूल.
अमूल फुल फॉर्म
Annual.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway, because you are all agricultural, professionals, so you should be having knowledge about. So, what is the byproduct of agriculture? You know. So, this is the valuable byproduct is one is the milk and its derivatives. So, other one is meat and its derivatives. Meat may be anything. No. So the major agriculture deals with the production of food. Okay, that's खेत में हम क्या क्या पैदा करते हैं? Maybe paddy, maybe sugar cane, maybe mangoes, maybe it's coconuts, what not? All those things, fruits, vegetables, anything which is fit for human consumption. So खेत में हम पैदा करते हैं. So उसके अलावा farmer का a secondary income होता है. So this secondary income generation sources also like buffalo, cow, sheep, donkey, horses. So all those things are helping the farmers to have some additional income, source of income. So iska matlab kya hota hai? So farming community mein secondary sources se thoda income bhi milta hai. So that secondary income in some places is the major income, major revenue. For example, now lot of research is being undertaken in developing those kind of secondary income. So one such is the man behind that particular revolution. It's called as a V. J. Kurian, Vargis J. Kurian was considered to be the pitamaha of cooperative movement, and particularly this revolution, cooperative revolution, in bringing that became a model in the entire country as well as world. So India is the largest producer of milk and its products than America. Though they consume more cheese, etc. So कितना हमको दुनिया में चाहिए उनसे 50% हमारा इंडिया में प्रोड्यूस होता है, स्पेशली मिल्क एंड मिल्क प्रोडक्ट्स. सो इसका आई थिंक यू बेटर क्लोज द डोर्स. सो ऐसे हो जाता है. सो दैट वे वी आर रियली सक्सेसफुल एंड थैंक्स टू the gentleman who was the person made that possible. So agriculture is not as big as that kind of cooperative movement we could be able to have. So isme kuch differences bhi ho jata. Abhi dekh lijiye, milk bole to कन्याकुमारी से लेकर टॉप हिमालय तक हमको काउस मिलेगा, बफलस मिलेगा, आपको शीप भी मिलेगा, उधर यू बी गेटिंग द मिल्क ओके ऑफ डिफरेंट एरियाज ओके. सो सिमिलरली बोथ द साइड्स नॉर्थ टू साउथ आई मीन डाउन साउथ एंड ईस्ट टू वेस्ट या ऑल दिस मिल्किंग काउस. So we'll get it. Similarly, in all the geographies in our country, we have what is called as cultivatable land. आपको समझ में आ रहा है cultivatable land बोले तो. So where the whole land ऐसा होता है उधर आप कुछ ना कुछ पैदा कर सकते हैं, cultivate भी कर सकते हैं, right? So wherever we're getting more water, especially the catchment area and the नदी परिवार योजना बोलते हैं ना, नदी परिवार एरिया राइट फ्रॉम गंगा, गंगा रिवर आल्सो फ्लोस इन बंगाल, बिहार, मध्य प्रदेश एंड यूपी इट्स ऑलमोस्ट कवर्स 7-8 स्टेट्स ओके. दिस द लॉन्गेस्ट रिवर एंड इसको बोलते हैं जीव नदी बोलते हैं. सो पूरा 12 महीने वाटर फ्लो तो रहता है. Volume may increase or decrease, but there is a flow always. So finally, that gets into the Bay of Bengal in West Bengal zone.
Yeah.
Right. So you just go along this river. All the places you find.
जाट दवाई है कि ना?
Right. Majorly two crops. One is paddy, other one is sugar cane. Sugar cane भी बहुत ज़्यादा पैदा होता है. So another crop, major crop in the three states, particularly I talk about West Bengal, Bihar and UP is potato, right? Potato. So now when you just produce so much of items, so how it is made possible? So when we get more of cultivatable land, less of population. समझ में आ रहा है आपको? इन 1940s और 30s हमारा जनसंख्या था सिर्फ 30 करोड़. सो वो टाइम में हमको कल्टीवेट करने के ज्यादा जमीन था, कल्टीवेटेबल लैंड था, मगर आदमी कम था. अभी आदमी का संख्या बढ़ गया मगर कल्टीवेटेबल लैंड का एरिया कम हो गया. सो इसलिए हमको देयर इज अ टू अदर थिंग्स आल्सो केम इनटू पिक्चर. What is that is called as you say the green revolution. Okay, green revolution. So paddy, lot of research is being undertaken by our Indian Council for Agriculture Research, and they produce so many varieties of rice. Hamara bachpan mein hum sunte the sirf do variety ka rice. Aaj hamare paas hai kam se kam over 100 varieties are grown in India.
400. Huh? More than 400.
Yeah. So, Akhtar sir ne bol rahe, it's a more than 400 varieties. Out of it, there are certain ancient rice varieties also available. Black rice, brown rice, you know, white rice, and a thin grain. And we have like, you know, GI tag wala, basmati rice. Basmati rice is another one. So we have such kind of rice. But of late, we, the Indians, eat more of rice than other staple food. So sabhi dhyan mein rakhiye. Global population closely reaching to 700 crores now. And it keeps on increasing. So will it be possible for us to have this kind of agriculture where we cannot produce more per acre land or per drop of water? So water ka bhi scarcity ho raha hai, seasons are changing because of climatic changes, right? So the global warming and what not, all those things we talk about. So looking at all these factors, now with whatever manpower is available, gaon se bhi bahut log they are all becoming graduates, and these people don't want to just undertake agriculture as a profession. So now we, the people, thinking progressively, and we have to make even cultivating should be equal to a software professional or like a civil servant. Civil servant kind of. Means we should be able to have the reverse migration to the villages. Thanks to COVID, it already impacted. So can you hear me? Well, my dear young friends, sometimes it's not possible for us to have seeing everybody's face because of the bandwidth problems. Okay. So maybe when you come to the university, very soon, maybe less than 30 days from now, we'll be able to have physical classes starting. Okay. So we'll make this particular program quite vibrant program. Right. So I'll just give a word on behalf of our university. So we don't leave any stone unturned in order to give you a proper insight into a total whatever is needed for you to have success in your profession. Okay. So we are having a lot of activities scheduled, and by the time you come, you'll be witnessing it. Okay, in a month or so. So anyway, coming back. So now this is the era. Now we are talking about for mechanization. So automation, remote management of agriculture, remote management. So maybe I'm there in Delhi, but I have some land in Bihar Sharif, and I'd like to see how my farming activity is going on and how it is being monitored. So maybe I got one aquaculture farm. So there, I have to see what is the salinity of the water every day and what is the health of all the stream which are there in my pond. And I'll be monitoring that, looking at my mobile, and accordingly I can just pass the instruction to the gadgets present there. It's not human beings, it's gadgets, okay? So they can do the remaining needful things. That means you'll be having a laboratory there to check the water condition, as well as diagnose the health condition of all the shrimp or the fish. And we can be able to dispense either the medicine for the shrimp or the fish, as well as improve the water quality. Maybe we'll be increasing the oxygen content of the water and decreasing the salinity of the water. No? So adding some nutrients, whatnot, all those things can be undertaken. So this is the...
Okay.
So now, this is the only introductory kind of thing I'm just giving you today. So probably I'll be taking about 10 hours for you to complete this particular portion. Okay. So this is actually a 2-credit course. 1 credit for the theory activity, which I will be doing it. And other one is practicals, you know, on the field, in the laboratory, both. And we're going to give you the wonderful experience of this particular laboratory on behalf of myself. Okay, I'll be personally involving in this, and I'm going to give you this. Coming back to again. Now, these are the 2 implements you are seeing on the screen. So one is the power tiller, we call power tiller. Other one is the tractor. And the gadgets, implements used for these 2 power equipment, okay, power machines. So you can see so many, lawn mower, whatnot, all those things can be attached to this power tiller, and you can get the work done. Okay. So now moving to the next slide. So farm power, already we had a different, the approach towards this. So in every sphere of activity, right from this seeding or the sample, putting a seeds, sowing to harvesting, we are resorting to the all kind of mechanization. We are using one or the other kind of machines or the tools. So you can see, we have got cultivators we have, flowing equipment we have, and carrying the dump trolley also we have. So all these are implements. These are called as agriculture implements. Okay, so we'll be having some power which is needed in order to use these implements. So that power will be getting through mechanical equipment powered by whatever sources which we'll be talking about. No, there are several kinds of sources we'll be talking about. Next, see what are the various powers we'll be using. So if just have a look at it, initially we had a human power, then we resorted to the animal power such that we could be able to increase. Maybe in some other class I'll talk about this. So like this, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different types of energy sources are the power types will be utilizing it. So you know, if it is human power, it takes a lot of time in order to till 1 acre of land. So with the help of animal, like maybe it may be a donkey or buffalo or horses or the oxen, you know, or a bullock, whatever you use it. So definitely that's going to help the reduce the human intervention and increase the area you can able to till, you know, or work. So that may be even for the harvesting, my paddy, like, you know, people take a small bunch and then hit on the some surface such that they can remove the paddy grains from the stack. So whereas if you use the animals, I remember we used to have a roller kind of thing and make these animals go round and round like a tractor now does the same activity.
Coal moving
kind of thing. Yes. So that's the kind of thing we used to have. We have to have a central pivoted kind of thing and have the buffalo or oxes kind of thing. They used to go around. So that's the way we used to have it. So we have seen the total transformation, right, from human power to animal power and mechanical power. Now we are using the electrical power because mechanical power has some limitations. So whereas electrical power is better and it's going to be smaller than that. So how we are going to replace with diesel? That means we don't want to use the fossil fuels because of greenhouse gases, you know, global warming. So we want to reduce the fuel, either diesel or the petrol usage for even agriculture implements. So we are just reverting to some other mechanism. Now we have a power sprayer, for example, to spray the pesticides. The earlier power sprayer was an IC engine, run started with the petrol and run with the kerosene. So dual mode fuel supply. So whenever you want to start that power sprayer, first you have to open the valve of petrol tank, then it can be started. Once it started, then put off the petrol supply and put on the kerosene supply. That was a two-stroke petrol engine. We used to use it, and it used to make so much of noise, lot of noise pollution. Okay. I'll just show you that. There may be a small video. I'll just add to my lecture, and I share those things in your WhatsApp group. Okay. So those equipment too. So, yeah. What is Chandan?
Chandan.
Yeah. Raise your hand. Yeah. You can ask Chandan. You can message.
No, sir.
Yeah. You can unmute and talk. Chandan, you can unmute and you can ask whatever you want.
Can I raise my hand by mistake, sir?
Okay, no problem. You can always disturb me. No issue. I am here to help you learn better. No, learning is more important than studying. That's right. Okay, thank you so much. So we'll be talking each and every element. What is that you are seeing here? Either human power, or animal power, mechanical power, and electrical power, and renewable energy sources. So biogas, again, it just we get from only farming community. Okay. So these things also will be discussing at length.
Time
is running out. 2 or 3 minutes more now. So until it just goes off, I'll just continue. We'll just use one particular slide. That's the last slide I'll give you. And okay, see this. So your contribution is going to be on the dining table of, or on the food plate of every citizen across the country, you know. So maybe whatever profession maybe they are in, you know, every citizen will be enjoying your contribution to the country. Is that right? Is it not wonderful to see these kind of things? You can see so many things. Okay, this is what is called a finished product. So you should learn how are you going to have this kind of finished product. So unfortunately, Amul was a success story because they are not selling only milk. So they use this milk to get other products. That means, so we are going to have end product directly consumable by the people. So that's the value addition to the products. So now, during your course of 3 years or 4 years, whatever time you will be spending in learning, maybe BS as well as afterwards, maybe you'll be doing MSc, whatever. No, so this, anything you're talking about producing, no, maybe you get a paddy, then it has to be hulled so that you get the rice. If you have that facility, then you are adding the value to it. So for example, Dawat rice. So Bihar se wo karitte paddy at throw a price, maybe 1200 to 1800 or 2000, the most max per quintal of paddy. Okay. And they sell it at 10,000 rupees a quintal. So this is the irony. Okay. So Amul was successful in bringing all the producers. See, individually, if you take it, so in your home, you have got only two oxes or two cows. They give only 10 liters of milk. You consume 2 liters. And 8 liters, you take it to your local dairy and get your money, maybe 40 rupees or 50, whatever money. Okay, so individually, if you see, it's very small, tiny. And as Amul, if you look at, it's a big. It's the world's largest milk producer of this country. And
as well as Amul. Now, you have to tell me that it's going to be a big deal. And what
was Deva?
It's okay. It's okay. Anyway, thank you. I think we'll have, again, we'll meet on suddenly scheduling the process. So as per the schedule, we'll be meeting. Okay. So thank you so much. Have a wonderful learning experience henceforth. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.